Hi, in today's lecture, we will look into the different types of planters and its components. So what are planters? So planters are equipments which are used to place seeds at regular intervals or distances at specific rates. The one difference between a seeder and a planter or a seed drill and a planter is that in a planter, the hill-to-hill distance or else the plant-to-plant distance is also maintained. So generally, planters are used for row crops when you need to have uniform spacing between two hills or two plants. So there are different methods of planting. We have the flatland, the bed or ridge, and the lister or furrow. So this is a picture of flatland planting. So here, plants are planted or seeds are planted in the field which is very flat and there is no slope or inclination. The second one is bed planting. In bed planting, the seeds or the seedlings or the plants are grown in small beds. Now these beds are separate and so each bed can have different varieties of seeds or crops. The third one is ridge planting. So ridge planting or furrow planting is where we plant crops along the ridge or along the furrow. So along the ridges we can see plants are being grown. So this is called as ridge planting. So in furrow planting we can see the seeds or the plants are placed in the furrows. So here we can see potato seeds are placed in the furrows. So what are the components of a planter? So there are many components of a planter. It is somewhat similar to that of a seeder. So the first one is a seed box. So similar to a seed drill, planter also has a seed box. Whereas in a planter, the seed box is smaller in size when compared to a seed drill. And it is more close to the ground for reducing the terminal velocity of the falling seeds. It is cylindrical in shape. And each row has separate seed hoppers. So there are different types of seed hoppers. We have the Richmond single seed cotton seed hopper, reverse seed cotton hopper, and the duplex hopper. So here we can see a picture of the Richmond hopper. So Richmond hopper is generally used for maize, tomato, and beans. The single seed cotton hopper has a horizontal plate fitted with an agitator and also a flexible leaf spring for preventing clogging of the seeds in the seed metering mechanism. The third one is the reverse seed cotton type of hopper. So here there are two wheels and both are rotating in opposite directions. So they also have a agitator fixed. So agitator will help for the uniform movement of the seeds in the hopper. And there is picker wheel attached to the hopper which will help to remove the seeds from the seed box. So the picker wheel metering mechanism is used for undelinted seeds. So the undelinted seeds are seeds where the lint is present. So the lint is nothing but the hairy component on the surface of the cotton seed. So delinted seeds are ones where the outer hairy component in the seed or the outer covering is removed. So if the hairy component is removed, then the seeds are called as delinted and we use cell type metering mechanism in that case. For undelinted seeds, the surface is still sticky. So we use the picker wheel metering mechanism in order to prevent clogging of the seeds in the hopper. The fourth one is a duplex hopper. So here there are two compartments. So we can use two varieties of seeds or you can use a single variety of seeds in both the hoppers. And also we can use only one hopper at a time. So for example, maize and beans simultaneously can be planted in the field using the duplex type of hopper. The second component of the planter is the seed metering mechanism. So the seed metering mechanism is also somewhat similar to that of a seed drill. So we have the horizontal plate planter, the vertical plate planter, and the inclined plate planter. And then we have the belt with the cell metering device and the pneumatic seed metering mechanism. So horizontal and vertical plate planters have already been described in the seed drill. And inclined plane also is similar to that of the horizontal or vertical type of seed metering mechanism. Here the plate is at an inclination of 60 degrees with the vertical. Then in the belt with cell metering mechanism, there is an endless belt with a number of holes attached. Now these belts move between pulleys. Now there is an extra roller pulley provided along the belt to push away extra seeds falling in the holes in the belt. So it can be used for all types of seeds. So that is an advantage with the belt type of seed metering mechanism. The last one is the pneumatic type of metering mechanism, which is very efficient and it reduces mechanical damage of the seeds. So here there is an air suction using an aspirator component in the planter, which helps the seeds to be sucked, and it gets fitted in the metering plate. Now this metering plate is always kept in a suction or in a vacuum condition. So as the metering plate rotates, at one point it cuts, it comes to a position where the vacuum is cut off. Once the vacuum is cut off, or once when the air suction is cut off, the seeds will fall under gravity from the rotating metering plate into the seed tube. So this is how the pneumatic seed metering mechanism operates in a planter. So here we can see the horizontal seed metering device. So here in the first picture we can see the front or the top view of the seed metering mechanism, which is a horizontal seed metering mechanism. So when we fit the seed metering device in the below the hopper through which the seeds pass through, so this is how it looks. So you can see the seed metering device. So it is along the horizontal direction. So this is a picture of the pneumatic precision planter. This pneumatic planters are high precision and they are very efficient, and they prevent clogging of the pores or the openings in the seed metering device. So here we can see the inclined metering device and then the belt type of metering device. So here we can see the roller, which is used for preventing excess seeds from filling the holes in the belt. The next component of the planter is the seed delivery mechanism. So we have the plain shank. In this type of delivery mechanism, a tube, an ordinary seed tube, is used for the delivery of the seeds from the metering device to the outlet. And then the next one is a high-speed double valve. In high-speed double valve seed delivery mechanism, there are two valves, a top valve and a bottom valve. So seeds fall from the top valve once they open, and then it comes to the bottom. So they get collected and they are regrouped depending upon the quantity of seeds to be placed in one furrow opening. And then the lower valve opens and the seeds will be placed in the field. The third one is a rotary valve type of delivery mechanism, where there is a single valve only at the bottom. On top, we have a rotating component or a rotor which has three or four cups mounted on the rim. So the seeds are picked up by the rotor or the rotating plate using the cups mounted on the rim, which is continuously revolved by a chain. Now the seeds flow through the chain and they are taken to the lower valve. So again there they are regrouped, and then they fall at when the lower valve opens, the seeds fall down into the furrow. The fourth one is a fertilizer metering mechanism. So there are two types of fertilizer metering mechanism. One is a star wheel and the other one is a revolving bottom plate. This has already been discussed during the lecture on seed drill. The fifth component of a planter is a furrow opener. So there are two types of furrow openers. One is a variable depth and the next one is a constant depth runner. So in a variable depth runner, the depth of penetration of in the furrow, or depth of the furrow to be made in the field, can be adjusted accordingly. So here we can see a picture of a rotating disc, which helps in the formation of furrows at different depths. So there are three sharp blades attached to the rotating component, and from the figure it is very clear how the different depth or the variable depth furrows are created in the field. The second one is a constant depth furrow openers. So there are different types of constant depth furrow openers. We have the hoe type, the runner type, and we also have the disc type. So in the runner type, we can see a flat plate is used, or the stubble runner is used for opening furrows. In a hoe type, we have this sharp blade or knife kind of a component, which is similar to a hoe or a handheld hoe. So that is used for opening the furrows. And then we have the disc openers. A disc opener also is similar to that of the openers in the seed drill. We have single disc or double disc type of openers, which are used for opening furrows. The last one is the lister type. So lister type is similar to that of a land leveler. So we have a flat plate, a horizontal plate, which moves parallel to the direction, it moves perpendicular to the direction of travel, and it helps to open up a furrow. The next component of a planter is the covering and the compacting devices. So there are different types of devices which are used for covering and compacting the soil in the furrows. So we have the open center wheel, we have the wheel with the central rib, we have a solid rubber wheel, we have a concave shaped rim, and the pneumatic with small lug wheel. So these are all different types of wheels which are used for covering the soil after the seeds are placed in the soil or in the furrow by the planter. We also have blades which can be used for covering the opened furrow. So types of planters. Now that we have seen the different components of a planter, let us see the types of planters. So we have the regular drill, the check row, and the hill drop type of planters. So potato planter. Potato planter is a special type of planter used exclusively for planting potato seeds. Potato is a very important component in our country, and it requires a lot of labor for sowing seeds. So we can use planters for reducing the time or the labor cost involved in planting of seeds in the field. So you have automatic planters, high speed automatic, and semi-automatic planters. So here a picture of the automatic planter is shown. So in automatic planters, there is a hopper for each row, and the cups are provided with the chain drive mechanism. So the graded potatoes or potato seeds are picked up by the cup, and they are taken to the furrow which has been opened up by the furrow opener. Now a feeder roller is connected to the compensating tray to check whether the correct number of potato seeds are falling in the seed metering mechanism. So here we have the cup type of seed metering mechanism. So the compensating tray helps to check or compensate for the reduced value or the increased value of seeds in the cup. So if the cup is empty, a seed is released. If a cup has an extra seed, again that moves to the compensating tray. So high speed automatic planter, it has two picker wheels, each having 8 picker arms. It is not as as fast as the name suggests. It is only faster than the automatic type of planter. The speed is slightly higher than that of the automatic type of planter. Otherwise, the components are still the same. The last one is a semi-automatic planter. So here it consists of a hopper, the metering device, and the furrow openers. So fertilizer application units can also be combined with the seed metering or the seed box for placing fertilizers along with the seeds. So here we can see the automatic planters, potato planters. So here the cup type of feed or the seed metering mechanism. Here you can see the picker wheel. So in here you can see the picker wheels, and these the potato seeds are found in between these plates, and as it moves down, the plate is continuously rotating. Now as this moves down, the plate or the metal component holding the potato loosens, and it falls into the seed falls into the ground. So here we can see the picker wheel mechanism in detail. The next type of planter is a sugarcane planter. So sugarcanes are generally, the seeds for sugarcane are called as sets. So here also the plant to plant or the hill to hill spacing, it needs to be maintained in the field. So row type of crop such as sugarcane requires planters for planting in the field. So here also there are separate provisions provided for chemical pesticides or fertilizers. So the machine consists of a hopper, two rotating distributor discs, two fertilizer hoppers, a pesticide tank with a distribution valve, and two furrow openers. So all these components are fitted to a frame and also to two wheels. So the seed distributor box and the applicator are powered from the ground wheel through a set of roller chains and gears. So they are not completely mechanized. There is no power supply directly from the movement of the ground wheel. The energy is transmitted to the seed distributor box through a set of roller chains and gears. So manually the seeds are put into the hopper. So here we can see a picture of the automatic sugarcane cutter planter, where the entire sugarcane is put as input into the hopper. The machine itself will completely cut the sugarcane into small sets and then place them in the field. In a semi-automatic planter, all the pre-cut sets, sugarcane sets, are filled up in the seed hopper. The next is the rice transplanters. So rice transplanters or rice planters are equipments used for transplanting the nursery the seedlings from the paddy seedlings from the nursery. If in the case of direct seeding, we do not require such equipments or transplanters, but if we are going to transplant the seedlings from the nursery, in that case we use the rice transplanters. So the power source can either be manual, animal drawn, or it can be power drawn. If it is power operated using power, it can either be from the tractor, or it can also be a part of the power tiller. So the type of nursery is very important for determining what type of seeds are to be placed in the field. So we have the root washed seedlings and the soil bearing seedlings or the mat type. In root washed seedlings, manual labor is used for uprooting the seedlings from the nursery, and they are tied into small bundles and they are washed in the water. So the roots are washed in the water to make sure that not much soil sticks to the roots. So it is called as root washed seedlings. In mat type of nursery, the seeds are placed in between mats or in between frames. Now these individual frames are called as mats, and then we place the seeds, we water it, and we allow it to germinate for about 28 to 30 days in the nursery. Once the seeds start to germinate, the frame is removed. Now each mat is considered as a separate unit and can be used as an input for the transplanter. So there are different types of planting fingers. We have the fixed fork type, the fixed fork and the knockout lever, the moving finger, and the rotating pincer type finger. In a fixed fork type, we have a fork or two parallel metal plates connected at the end. So that helps to remove the seedlings from the mat. In a fixed fork and knockout lever type, it is the same as that of the fixed fork type, except that there is a lever which knocks out the seedlings in between the fork. And then in moving finger, we again have two metal plates parallel to each other, which helps to remove the individual seedlings from the mat. And then in the rotating pincer type finger, we have two components or two rotating discs which help to remove the seedlings from the mat. Now these seedlings are held in between the two rotating discs. So here we can see a picture of the different types of rice planters. So here I have shown a picture of the self-propelled rice type of planter. So here we can see the mat, which is given as the input for the transplanter. So here is a picture of the manual type rice planter, a power tiller mounted rice transplanter, a self-propelled type of rice transplanter. Thank you.